It's better than the $500 you're going to spend.
Business.
Writing, producing, acting.
Hey, welcome back to The Casting Couch. I am Todd Stroik, your host.
And I'm Carrie Kavanaugh.
And we are here and happy to have a wonderful man with us. His name is
David Zimmerman.
He is a coach, he is an actor, and he runs wonderful workshops. He's been doing that for over a decade here in LA. He is a creator and producer of Meet the Biz workshops, which are very happy to announce that they've just received a wonderful grant from the Christopher and Dana Reeve Foundation.
Yeah, he's also a casting director. He's cast pilots for Showtime, for Star Price Productions. As an actor, you can see him on the big screen in Meet the Fockers,
Ooh.
Hyde. And he does a little web series called Child of the 70s.
Yeah,
so,
and it is so much fun. Why don't we check out some of his work?
I think that would be a good idea.
Good.
Some of the cousins.
I met some, yes.
I'm Don Parker.
Of course.
Yes, I've totally seen that man's face.
Everywhere.
I think it was maybe pictures in stalls in men's bathrooms.
Oh, well.
No? Oh, I guess you wouldn't know.
And why would you?
All right, well, here he is. My friend and yours, Mr. David Zimmerman.
Woo!
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming on. I'm going to give you a hug.
Oh,
and let me tell
you.
Did
you see that?
I put the pictures in the stall.
I knew it! I knew I saw his faces in those men's rooms.
That's right. I have to put them somewhere. I have so many, you know.
Well, you know what? Here's the thing. You do anything you can to get your headshot out there, right?
Yep.
I do the same thing. I've left them in men's rooms and women's rooms. You know, I've gotten some calls.
Taco Bell.
Not gonna lie.
Okay.
Gone in some, you know, I don't really want to do porn, but
no,
you know,
hey,
those are the calls I get. So
they need to stand in, you're there now.
That's right. Okay, so
yes.
On to David.
I haven't cast porn yet.
Okay, tell us about yourself.
Me?
Yeah. Jack of all trades.
Well, if I was to write a autobiography, it would be called My Name is Sybil.
Oh.
Because I do a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I produce, I cast, I still act. I act. I run the Meet the Biz workshops.
Right. And what exactly is that for people that are like, what is Meet the Biz?
But before we get into Meet the Biz, I want to ask you a question.
Yes.
Out of all those things that you do, what is your favorite thing to do?
Oh, you know, I have to say it depends on the moment.
Mm. Oh,
I mean, the thing is, what I really love, I love sitting in one of the workshops, actually, and seeing the instructor or the students, and they're smiling, mm-hmm. and they're learning, and they're growing. And I just, you know, one of my favorite things in life is to see others be happy.
You know what? I can attest to this.
Mm-hmm.
When I was shooting on the feature,
mm-hmm.
I remember it was probably like one of my fondest memories was actually David coming up to me in between shots and being like, I just love watching you work. It's just so much fun.
Well, you're stunning.
Yes.
Well,
I do what I can.
You're
great.
Makes this job hard.
Okay, so but you mentioned, and we mentioned, Meet the Biz.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Let's talk about that.
Meet the Biz is a group of workshops where we bring in different industry professionals at very low rate, because we all know how actors, you know, only have so much money. And the thing about Meet the Biz is it's a group of actors who happen to have with and without disabilities.
Okay.
So you're in a workshop and you're doing scenes with somebody who might be blind or deaf,
wow.
or quadriplegic, or you or me.
Mm-hmm,
so it's
mm-hmm.
all groups, you know, it's a group getting together.
That's great.
And working, not just meeting. Somebody on Facebook said, I'm not going to come to a class, you know, who just, you know, you're going to meet people. And I say, no, this is workshops. 4 weeks with Lainey Kazan.
Ooh, love her.
Mm-hmm.
Bruce Davison mm-hmm. from X-Men. Mm-hmm. Amazing people.
So what do you do in the workshops? Like, give us an example of, you come into class.
We come into, it's like an acting workshop.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Charlene Tilton, she will, you know, we'll have maybe a half an hour interview and Q&A, and mm-hmm. she'll get to know everybody. And then the rest of the 4 weeks, it's scene study. She'll mm-hmm. give you scenes. You'll take them home. You'll work with different scene partners. Each person who comes in, I say, hey, it's your time to do what you want. Danny Woodburn does improv for 4 weeks. And then we have the single night workshops, which right now is under the grant, which is the 40.
Right.
And it's really about meeting people and working with people and...
But that's what this town is about.
Well, yeah, and working on your craft.
So what you're saying is workshops are important. Classes are important, right?
No, yeah. I mean, some people think they could just come to L.A. and do it without workshops. And I have to say, there are one or two out there who can do that. They're just naturals. But
or they look like a supermodel.
Right. And at the same time, I really believe that the industry is opening up to you don't have to look like a supermodel right now. It's definitely changing. And, you know, we go through these ups and downs. That's why these classes are so wonderful, too. Because we have all these different people. We have the director, producer, writer of What the Bleep. We have directors coming in. Now, I love casting director workshops. I love them. And we have some casting directors coming in too, but why not bring the director?
Right.
Who's actually doing it?
Who's in charge of really deciding who gets cast. So what are you working on right now?
We are working on a film called My Next Breath.
A
feature film.
Great.
We shot 60 hours of footage like 4 or 5 years ago.
Oh, wow.
And it was sat on, which was a blessing because 5 years later, we come back to this. It's about a group of performers, actors, mm-hmm. who get together in this room and open up. And their stories become the movie. And it's more about what the audience can relate to. It's about the breath that we all take. What do you want the most at this moment in your life? And are you using?
Wow.
Are you using your breath?
So is it like a documentary?
It's a documentary.
Okay.
It's about a group of people. And then 5 years later, what have they done? And it's amazing to see what they have done, what they wanted to do, what they didn't get to do, and how we can all relate to that.
Right.
You know, it's about family.
I kind of feel like when you're in L.A., if you want to be successful, you need to find your family here.
Create that family for yourself. Mm-hmm.
Well, you don't create
it. Well, I mean, you do in a sense.
You're not going to go in and draw characters and be like, here, I'm creating this character.
No, but they're connections that you make with the people that you, you meet.
Like my little Gary Kavanaugh.
And this is my family, right?
Yeah, no, it's true. It's true. I mean, as you get older and you're
I'm not getting older.
Do you see this?
Dorian Gray, I've been looking all over.
I've got enough Botox in these lines.
Oh my God.
I'm keeping it down. Listen, I'm 29 forever.
When I get older, I'm going to look like Katharine Hepburn. Yeah. So, you know, I'll let it go, whatever.
Okay. Good luck with that.
You know, when you get older and your blood family moves on to other places, you feel sometimes lost, which I did at a time. And then I looked around me and they were right in front of me. And I was blessed by that because sometimes you can't always find the good people.
Yeah. Right.
Because, you know, as we know, L.A. can get fishy at times.
Yeah.
But I've been blessed with that.
Right. Great.
What's some of your advice for, I mean, I think surrounding yourself with a good family is great advice for people coming to L.A. What other bits of advice that you can give to actors out there that are thinking about coming to L.A.?
They're not here yet.
Be prepared. I mean.
In what way?
Don't just think you're going to make it like, you know, kick in the bucket and say, you know, hey, here I am.
Yeah.
I haven't studied, but I'm going to, you know, do the work. And, you know, one or two people can do that. But, I mean, you know.
One or two people out of a million.
Out of a million.
You know, are you one of those two people? I doubt it.
Right. And do you really want to be like that? Yeah. Don't you want to be like the greats, like Cate Blanchett or you know.
Jessica Simpson.
Oh. Ian McKellen.
Yeah, yeah.
Right.
You know,
you've
got to
study your craft. You've got to be prepared, be ready when you come out.
That's right.
Right.
And then continue studying when you get here.
And when you get a little nuts, when you feel like, oh my God, the pressure of LA because it gets, you know, when you get there to that point and say, I need a break, take a weekend away. Take a month away if it gets to that
serious point. I know, it can be very hard. I have a very hard time leaving LA. I'm like, no, I can't leave. I'm going to miss something. But you know what? You need to get away.
You need to take a minute. Yeah, I just took a minute.
There's always going to be something filming.
Yep.
There's always going to be someone casting. There's always going to be someone producing. Someone's going to be writing something. Yes. Always. LA isn't going anywhere.
Right.
It's okay to leave for a little while and take a break and just refresh yourself.
Right. And you know what? Be true to yourself. Right here.
Mm.
Right here. Because that's the one thing I kept with me when I first moved here. I said, David, the one thing you got to do is be true to yourself. And there were struggles, you know, roommate struggles, getting cast and then not getting cast struggles, getting cast, getting awards, not, you know, whatever it is.
Right.
On your journey through this life and through LA. Also, having that time that you need to get away. You need to live life. Mm-hmm. It's about living life, exploring yourself. It's not just about, I got to audition, I got to act, I got to this. You got to
Which is very easy in LA because this is going on all the time. We have, you know, multiple auditions, casting workshops,
callbacks, putting things on video. We need to read a script.
You know, we get into our own little boxes and we get, you know, in there. And we have to remember to become the best actor, we have to take it all in. Take
experience
it all in.
Life,
death, living life to the fullest, love, loving. Mm-hmm. It's all of that stuff. It's all of that wonderful stuff.
That's great.
So where can people find you, David? How can people get a hold of you?
www.davidzimmerman.biz or www.meetthebiz.net.
So they can find out about workshops in LA.
Yeah, you can find out about the workshops where you can register for the 40. Space is limited.
Right.
And there's only 25 people per workshop. So.
Ooh, 25 per workshop.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you sign up for the ones you want.
Right. Mm-hmm. Are you on Twitter?
I am on Twitter. I just got on Twitter.
Amazing.
And I am on Facebook.
So make sure you follow me.
Yes. Okay. Follow.
Well, David, thank you so much for being here. God, it was so great to see you again.
Oh,
be back
thank
out
you.
On set
this
with
was
you
fun.
Again. So much great information that you've got out and meet the biz.
Yeah.
Hopefully we can get some of our viewers will come out and
it's gonna be great.
I mean,
it's gonna be great.
You can't beat that.
Absolutely. All right, and thank you guys for tuning in this week again to The Casting Couch.
I'm Carrie Cavanaugh.
I'm Todd Stroik. Don't forget to follow us, The Casting Couch, on Facebook. Thanks again, and we will see you next time.
And flashes in California. Paper hoes and playboys pump me full of celluloid. We keep it tight almost every night. Red carpet style ain't a door to fight. We do it right.